heard it said that this here's a man's world. And some girls, they believe it. Primping and fussing and holding out, hoping a boy will look her way. They don't know they got the power.
You say, oh, girl, it's a cold world when you keep it
on. As for me, well, I'm not that kind of girl.
We're running with the shadows of the night, so baby, take my hand.
So if it's a man's world, God wouldn't have made me.
Talk about Melissa Manchester, because she's obviously got to be a big driving force in your...
Oh my God, totally. I mean, when I was a kid, her music sort of meant the world to me. And when I wrote the script, I purposely worked in a lot of her songs into the script, saying, okay, she's going to be, you know, the guiding light for my character Clark. And luckily, she has 4 decades of music to choose from, and so when we, it was kind of great, because when we first went into production, we needed her permission, obviously, to use her image, and so I wrote this really sort of like psycho stalker fan letter to her manager, and was not, you know, it should come as no surprise, but I got no response, and thanks to Facebook, I met up with an old friend who was a conductor back when I was a Broadway dancer, and he says, what are you up to? And I said, I'm working on this movie, and you know, I'm trying to get Melissa Manchester involved. And he's like, well, you know, I know her. And I said, I don't. He said, I conducted her last tour. And I said, okay, well, just do me a favor and tell her I'm normal. Just tell her that I'm not psycho. Just let her know that, you know, you don't have to do anything else than that. You don't have to do any more than that. Just say, you know, I vouch for him. And a couple of days later, this email came in. It said, from Melissa Manchester in the inbox, and she's become just a fantastic friend to the film.
I was going to say, I wondered how hard it was to get her, but you just answered that question.
Oh, okay. Third question.
I'm convinced,
funky boss,
that I have the happiest family there ever was.
Coffee, tea on me, baby. To shit your lane. My opening line might be a bit passé, yes. But don't think that I don't know what I'm feeling for you. Cause I got a vibe on you the first time that I saw you. I need your love, and I won't bring no pain. A little birdie told me that you feel the same. I'm for the real, and for you I'm true blue. Let's make a deal, sugar, all I wanna do is...
Music was fantastic, but the second thing in that film that I just have to bring out is the Bugle Boy Jane line, which had me laughing for at least 20 minutes.
Thank you
after.
For getting it. It's like, it's a very specific reference, and I think people who, you know, were of a certain age in the 80s, you know, they laugh really hard, and then like some of the really young kids are kind of like, I don't get it. Why is everybody laughing?
Right.
And I think that's the humor of the film. It's very, you know, the themes of the film are universal, but there are moments that you had to have lived to understand, and that's one of them. And it just depends on the audience. We had a, you know, we have this other joke about, you know, going to the beach in Fresno, and we premiered in Toronto, and I think it's the funniest joke in the movie. We premiere in Toronto, nobody laughs. We come, we show the movie in New York, nobody laughs. We get to LA, there's a big chuckle. We show the movie in Fresno last week, and they laughed for 35 seconds. So it's the movie is kind of filled with those moments that it's like, okay, this is just for you, and everybody else, you know, it's just for the right people will get the joke. So.
The most authentic talent show ever. Can't remember the name of the group. Is the
Perpetual Motion.
Perpetual Motion.
Yeah.
I swear I have the same outfit I wore in my 8th grade talent show to Fleetwood Mac.
I have it too.
Do you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So talk about the costume design.
That was really fun. My choreographer, Bill Zabodi, and I, we go back a long way. And the costume designer, Mary Claire Hannon, had been a dancer as well. And so we were kind of talking about, you know, the particular line of the leotard. And this had to look like the girls made the costumes themselves. And so we just sort of put that together. I mean, I spent a lot of time in high school talent shows. I was on my high school dance team. So we had a lot of references to pull from. But I think the crowning achievement was the little braided chiffon headbands.
And the little scarves.
And the scarves on the hands. Well, it makes
exactly.
Things flow.
Exactly.
It makes things flow. And all those girls, they were all Bill's students from Pepperdine. Those were all Pepperdine girls in a movie called Dirty Girl. So I hope they...
it was fantastic.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much.
sister, you don't know who you're dealing with.